The next one we are going to see about the law of conservation of energy. Okay, very important. Law of conservation of energy. You studied in the 9th class. Conservation means saving. Okay, without wasting, we save. In the chemical reactions, when it is takes place, so how much reactants are there, that much product we get. Without, so during the chemical reaction, the energy is not wasted or the energy is not created. That means new energy is not added. So what is the energy is there initially, the same energy will be converted into another energy without wasting or without adding the some other energy. It is called as a law of conservation of energy. Okay. So now you see law of conservation energy. Now here, so here we will see now whether the transformed, that means changed form of energy is useful or waste. The entire electric energy converted, so the entire energy is converted into another form without wasting. So it is called as a law of conservation of energy. In other words, energy can neither be created not destroyed. That means during the chemical reaction, neither, so it is not created, that means not new energy is not added or nor destroyed, it is not destroyed. So it can be only be transformed from one form to another form. Energy can only transform, change from one to the, for example, potential energy to the kinetic energy. Here the chemical energy, what is in the firecrackers, changed into the light energy, sound energy, thermal energy and kinetic energy. So it will be changing from one form to the other form without wasting or without adding the new energy. So it is called as a law of conservation of energy. Okay. So here the following table will give us how it is changing from one form to the other form. Okay. Electrical appliances. The electrical appliances we use at home. Okay. So from one, which electrical energy is converted into another form. For example, for using, another one is wasted. For example, TV, electrical appliance TV. TV will be producing which energies? Light energy and sound energy. Okay, because of light we can see the picture in the, what is that, in the TV, and sound is also produced. And one more energy, when this in the TV, the electrical energy, when it is changing into the light, it will be changing into light energy, sound energy and thermal energy. But in these three energies, only two energies are useful energies which is formed. But another thermal energy, the heat is also produced after watching TV sometime. When we touch the TV or any that switches, it will be hot. That means thermal means heat. The heat energy is produced, but that heat energy is a wasted energy. Okay, that means the TV, what the electrical energy changing into three forms of energy, light energy, sound energy and thermal energy, but only two energies are useful and one energy is wasted. All the electrical energy will be changing into these three forms without wasting or without adding any other energy. Then hair dryer, to dry up our hair after taking bath. So it will be changed into kinetic and thermal energy of air molecules and sound energy. Sound energy is not useful, which is transformed, okay, which is formed. And two energies are useful. Oven, thermal energy, food gets warm. In the oven, food will be getting warm. Which energy is wasted after converting? It is the thermal energy. Okay, thermal energy and sound energy. And fan. Fan will be changing into, fan will be moving now when you put on the fan. So it is a kinetic energy. And one more energy which is the wasted, sound energy. Why here we say waste energy means, all the energy which is present in this, it will be changing into these three energies. Okay. Light, sound and thermal, but two energies only used, but thermal energy is not used, it is wasted. So like this, here they have given us some pictures. What we use? Electric energy, tungsten bulb. Okay, in this bulb, tungsten is there. So in this tungsten, that electrical energy is changed into two: thermal energy and light energy. Light energy is used, but thermal energy, that after some time when we put on that when we touch the bulb, it will be hot. Okay, so that heat energy is wasted. All the electrical energy which is flowing in the wires to reach to this bulb, all the energy will be changed into another form: thermal energy and kinetic energy, light energy. So in this, light energy is useful and thermal energy is wasted. So for example, nowadays everybody are using this kind of lights, LED. That means what? Light emitting diodes. And then one CFL means compact fluorescent lights. So than this light, these two are very useful and very good, because it will not waste the more energy. For example, CFLs, compact fluorescent lights, it will be using that 70% of light energy, but this is using only 10%. So than this, it is very better. But the how much is wasted light energy? 390% of thermal energy, heat energy is wasted. And then electric energy, light emitting diodes. Light emitting diodes is useful what? It is changing into thermal energy. Only less energy is wasted. 95% energy, light energy is used. So it is very very good. This light is very good, because how much electricity is flowing, that much it will be using without wasting. Only 5% is only wasted. Here 390. But 70% of light energy is used. But here only 10%. That's why the brightness of this light is less. And the brightness of this light is lesser than this. And the brightness of this light is more, because of the more percent of light energy is used. Then energy transfer. In the chapter on heat and temperature, we read about transfer of thermal energy. Thermal energy can be transformed into three ways: conduction, convection, and radiation. Knowing how thermal energy is transferred from hotter objects to colder objects can help us control loss of thermal energy. We studied already what is conduction, convection, and radiation in the last chapter. Okay, so conduction is what? Producing the heat. Conduction takes place in solids. So heat will be transferred from one molecule to the other molecule in the rod. And then convection means it changes, takes place in the liquids. So the first, the high, what is that, when the water is heated up, the hot molecules, it will be coming down and it will makes the cold water to be hot. So fluids exchange will be taking place. In the convection, in the radiation, what is taking place? Radiation take place in the vacuum. Through the radius waves and through the micromagnetic waves, we get the heat. Thermal means heat. So thermal radiation, thermal energy takes place in three forms: conduction, convection, and radiation. Okay, so law of conservation of energy. For example, one example I will tell you. For example, here electrical energy. Okay, so electrical energy, it will be changing into what? It will be changing into light energy plus thermal energy. Heat is also produced in the bulb. Thermal energy and light energy. So the whole electric energy in the chemical reaction will be converted into another forms of energy. That means in this, without wasting, without creating new energy, how much electrical energy is used, that much energy is produced. Okay, so it is called as a law of conservation of energy.